very clearly. You have to choose now. Plain, simple warning. Yes to God or no? The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in the field. You have to dig. You have to search for it. Because when you find it, it will give you a new heart. It will give you a new life. Your desires are changed. Everything now is for God. And then, pray for God. And then the pearl. The kingdom of heaven is like also a pearl. Pearl meaning wisdom. Pray for the gift of discernment. It will give you a new mind. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 16 says, you start to see as God sees. Isn't that beautiful? You see as God sees. And you think as God thinks. And then, of course, everything. That's the work of the kingdom of God. And then the question here is a warning to you and to me. Probably you have said yes. That's why you're here in the class. Right? Because if you are not prepared to say yes, probably you won't be here. Or am I putting much into it? The answer is known only by you. Right? The only thing I can tell you is there's that warning from the Lord. Do you say yes to Him or no? Maybe some of us will say, but wait. I'll tell you later. I'll tell you later. The Hispanics say, hasta luego. Mañana. Otro mes. Otro año. But the question is, do you have the time? We don't know. Do you know? Can you say, okay, yes. I'll say yes to you tomorrow. I'll wait until I get my big check. After I get my big check, I'll deposit, I'll cash it, then I'll say yes. Remember that man in the Bible, I have so much harvest. I need to build a new barn. There's not enough room for my harvest. I have so much harvest. So I will build a much bigger barn where I can store all my yield, all my harvest. And what does the Lord say? You fool, tonight I'm claiming you back. You and I might not have time. So the time to say yes is now. Now is the time. If you are not prepared to say yes now, you better think again. I did not lack in reminder. The purpose of the class, especially tonight, is to dare you this morning. Yes? Deal or no deal? It's up to you. I cannot do much more. I have many Bible verses here concerning that, but I think this is clear enough. I have come across you, right? Oh, at least they see this on, because this is very crucial. Now, who loves sports? You love sports? Not much. I don't know about you, but I see people around walking, they wear jerseys, right? With big numbers in the back. And some of their favorite players' names in the back.
I don't even know the names because I could care less about those. But you can see the wild interest in sports for those people, right? Understand? If you are wildly interested in God, would you wear something that would declare to the world that you are one of them? That you are one with Him? Are you prepared to do that? Oh no, it's shameful. I don't want to be out of place in at work. Do you feel sometimes that way? When you're eating out, do you pray before eating? Do you make the sign of the cross or you're ashamed? You don't want to be seen. You're ashamed. Jesus says, if you're ashamed of me, what happens? I'll get ashamed of you. I don't want to erase this. Can I erase this? It's okay.